Hello everyone. In the previous class we started our topic is like memory hierarchy. But in that class we just not completed the topic, right? So now in this class again we will discuss the topic. So after that what we have, right? So actually in the previous class we discussed like primary storages. Okay, so like in the primary storages what we have, ROM and RAM. Read-only memory and random access memory. Okay, I will explain again. Okay, so first go with this. Next, what we have, your internal memory, and also we have the secondary memories, right? See here, in this previous class we discussed this one, right? So these are all in the previous class we discussed. Okay, so actually we have like a primary memory, internal processor memory, secondary memory, right? In that we already discussed the ROM and the RAM. So mask ROM, PROM, EPROM, EEPROM, static RAM, dynamic RAM, cache memory, we completed this. So now in this class we will discuss the, our next topic is like internal processor memory. After that we will go with the second memory, okay, right? So in this class we will discuss first internal memory. Internal processor memory. Second one, what we have here? Internal processor memory. Second one we have internal processor memory. Okay, so here what is internal processor memory? First of all, here what is internal processor memory? Okay, so your internal processor memory is just working with the one type, is like registers. It is working with the only one type, we can call that is the registers. Okay, so here we have the one topic is like registers in the internal storage memory, right? Then how you are performing these registers, right? How you are performing these registers? What is the meaning of the register? Okay, what is the use for this? Let's go. So your registers are performed like high speed temporary memory components. Here these registers are performed like high speed temporary memory. Here it is working the high speed, but it is in the temporary value. Temporary means your, once you are switch off the computer, it just lost the memory. High speed temporary loss. High speed within the fraction of second. Suppose you are listening the all the classes, right? I don't know how many of listening the classes. Suppose you are asking what is the computer. Okay, so no one can reply. I know no one can reply. Okay, so means you are just, you are lost in the your data within the speed, within the fraction of seconds. Okay, here high speed temporary memory. Actually temporary means here everything we are storing in the temporary manner only. Okay, so normally you are I'm studying. Okay, so in that time you are not only me, you also. Okay, so you're just, you're taking the, okay, computer means here this is the electronic device, and like this we are imagining. Okay, we are reading and we are understanding that one. Okay, just we are reading and understanding. For what purpose you are, for the exam purpose we are writing the our knowledge, we are using the knowledge, right? But after that here we are removing that, after that we are removing those information from our mind. Means here within the seconds only we can forget everything. Within the seconds only we can forget anything. So means here these registers are with high speed temporary memory. These are the temporary, and within the high speed it is working. Okay, and your this is the high speed temporary memory components. So those are working for the different types of storages. Okay, so these registers are working with the high speed temporary memory. So this is capable to perform different types of storing information. It is using the different types of storing information. How it will be stores here, like data, okay, or else it is storing the instructions, okay, or else it is storing the address type, okay, etc. Okay, yes, by using this high speed temporary memory, it is just why we are using means here it is storing different types of information. Okay, what we have the types means here data, instructions, address. Okay, so your work, you're giving the information means here you're working the data. Okay, and in that data we are giving the some instructions, and where we need to be locate that one, we are using the address for that. We are using the address for that, right? And your normally here store this information is having the CPU means here, yes, we are storing every information, data or instructions, everything. So this can be stored into the our CPU. These are all stores into the our CPU. Means here it is performing the what your users are giving the instructions, and here the CPU is working the instructions by the users. Okay, so in where it is performing by the CU, by the CU. Okay, so in the anatomy of computer you have, okay, means your block diagram of computer. So in the control unit, your control unit is managing input device, output device, and also it is managing arithmetic logic units, and also it is maintaining the memory unit. Okay, so here every information is working here control unit means here it is taking the input and processing it, and also it is giving the output to the monitor screen means here it is transferring the instructions to the every persons. Okay, so this control unit can perform like arithmetic operations, or else it can be performs like logical comparisons also. So here what your users are giving, those instructions are performed by the our CPU. In that CPU, which one is processing means here our control unit is processing all these things. Okay, so and your so anything you can give, any other instructions, anything will be performed by this, right? So in these registers we have these some types. Okay, let's go your types of registers. Types of registers. So what we have your types of registers here, these are also taking the some data, some instructions and some address. Okay, so here what we have the different types of registers. First register is the program counter register. First register is the program counter. We can call this one is the PC. Program counter we can call like a PC. Okay, register. PC register. We can call here program counter is like a PC. Okay, so this program counter is storing the information about the next instruction. Here this is storing the information about not present instructions. It is taking the what you are doing the next step, that is taking the next instructions to perform in this. Means here it is ready to perform. It is ready to get ready to perform next instructions. It is not taking the current instructions. Okay, so here what you are storing the information about the next instruction that needs to be executed here. Okay, so in this program counter register you are performing the storing information. Okay, what you are storing information, so for what we are storing this one, about the next instructions. Okay, so what you need to be execute. Okay, what you need to be execute, so that only you are storing. So at that is not at the current instructions, those are the next instructions. Those are the next instructions to us, right? And next we have the second type is like instruction register. Second type is like instruction register. Okay, we can call this one is the IR. We can call this one is the IR, instruction register, right? This instruction register is taking the some instructions, those are performing like decoding in the control unit. Yes, we have the coding and decoding. Okay, so just we have done the coding for that. Means here again we can perform the decoding decoding performance. Like suppose your human's language can be converted into machine language, right? Again, your this machine level language your processing after it is giving the output to the users, right? So how it will be giving? It is not giving the zeros and ones. Binary format, it is again giving the human's language, readable language, right? So like that only here we are performing the decoding for our outputs. Okay, so here where we are performing this decoding, in the control unit we are performing this decoding. Okay, so your instructions are required to be decoded by control unit. What we are giving the instructions, those are okay decoded by control unit. Okay, decoded by control unit. Here, what you are giving those instructions can be controlled, means here, decoded by the our control unit. And next, we have the third one is like memory address register. Memory, okay, address. Okay, next, we have the memory address register. We can call this memory address register is also MAR, in the shortcut MAR. Okay, so here in this also we are storing the some information. So for what here we are storing the information? For the address here. Okay, register store the information about the address, means here in which location we need to be place this information we are storing. Okay, we are storing for in where we are storing. Actually we have these some drives like C drive, E drive, D drive. Okay, suppose you are opening your computer. So your previous I save the one file. Okay, so like in the D drive, suppose here I save that file in the D drive. So directly here I'm telling you like yes, that file is in the D drive. Okay, so means here here I'm telling you like one location. Okay, or else here you are going somewhere. Okay, so anyone is asking you where are you, like okay, so just you are telling like yes, I'm in this location, right? So means you're same like that, what you're storing the information. Okay, we are calling that one is the address for that. Okay, but we have the address, but where we have that location, where we have that location, so by that location only we are calling the address for that. Right here it is taking the next location, so it is storing that one. So in this also we are taking the next location for. Okay, so your okay, memory address register is taking the like stores the information here. This register stores the information about the address. Okay, and this address is belongs to the next location. This address is belongs to the next location that can be stored in the memory. That can be stored into the memory. That can be stores into the memory. And next here we have the fourth one, memory buffer register. Fourth one we have memory buffers register, MBR. Next we have the memory buffers register. Next we have the memory buffers register, means here in this also we are storing the information. Okay, means here we are storing the some data, so that data can be transferred by the CPU. Okay, it is transferred by the CPU and it is transferred to the CPU also. So what you are taking the data, okay, so this data can be transferred by CPU. Okay, and also this can be transferred to CPU. So without CPU is getting, how it will be transferred to another? No, right? So your transfer the CPU is getting the byte transfer and it is getting the to transfer. Okay, here what it is performing? Data. Okay, memory is taking the buffering. I think everyone knows the buffering. So it is in the loading performance. Suppose you are watching any movie or anything, so it is showing like a loading. means you're at that time you don't have any proper network, means you're, it is showing like a buffering. Okay, so you have to be wait some time. Once here it is loaded, you will get again moving. Okay, right. So here it is like a memory buffer registers. Okay, this can be storing the data. So that data can be in the transferred by CPU, or else that data can be in the transferred to CPU, anything, right? And next here we have the accumulator. Okay, and next here we have the another one is like accumulator. Accumulator, we can call this one is the ACC. Accumulator we can call like ACC, right? This accumulator register is the responsible for storing temporarily result. Here what is the use? It is storing the temporary results. Okay, storing temporary only, it is not saving so many years, so many hours like this. It is just working temporary result. For just restoring like a temporary results. Okay, so as well as it is also performing the results for arithmetic logic unit, and also it is performing the results for arithmetic logic unit. Arithmetic logic unit, and also it is performing the. So here accumulator is why we are using means here. This is also storing the information. So for what your this stored information is in the just temporary. Okay, what you are giving the instructions and what you are performing, those can be in the temporary value, temporary file. Okay, so once you are switching off your computer, it is just lost the data. And your this accumulator is also performing the arithmetic logic unit. Means here this accumulator is working for the calculations. This accumulator is working for the calculations, means your addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus division, and or not everything will be worked by the our accumulator. Okay, and next here last one we have the data register. Okay, we have the data register. Okay, this data register is we can call like a DR also. We can call this one is like DR also. Okay, so this data register is storing the information, so that can be performs like operands in the other data. Okay, so here it is taking this data register is also storing the information. That information can be associated with the some operands, okay, and other data. So here this is also working for storing information only, but in this we are working the operands. Here what is operands? Operators in the operands we have. Okay, what is operands means here, suppose you are taking the 2x plus 3y. Okay, or else you can take the x plus y. Or else you can take the x plus y. Your plus is the operator, x and y are the operands. Okay, so here what you are storing, so that can be in the operands, or else it is in the data situation. Okay, so these are the our internal processor memories. And next, what we have your secondary storage memory. Second, primary memory completed, internal process completed, and next here we have the secondary memory. Third one, what we have? Secondary memory. Okay, in this memory also we have the types, right? So first discuss what is secondary memory. Okay, so secondary memory we can call like auxiliary memory also. Your secondary memory we can call like auxiliary memory also. Auxiliary memory we can call this secondary memory is also auxiliary memory. So yeah, this secondary memory is the one of slowest and cheapest form of memory. This memory is this very slow, and also it is very cheapest memory, cheapest form of memory. Here this secondary memory is the slowest and cheapest memory here, secondary memory, right here. So why? Because your inside these memories cannot be processed directly by the CPU. Why we are calling this is the slowest and cheapest here? Inside, yes, we are giving the instructions or everything, right? So why it is not performing inside? This is the computer work, right? Why we need to be involved in that? We don't know, right? So here, why it is slowest and cheapest means here, what you are giving the memories, those are not working inside. Those are not working processing or anything. So directly it is not working by the CPU. Okay, so it is depending on the any other persons. Okay, so means here, initially just it is copying the data. Okay, so where it is copying? Okay, the secondary memory, it is copying into primary storage prior to processing. Okay, so first actually it is taking the storage like a secondary memory. Okay, so this secondary memory is transferring this information to the like a primary memory. Means here what we have here, ROM and ROM. Okay, so this secondary memory is sending the what you stored information to the our RAM and ROM. So means it is not having the any own situation, own knowledge like that. Okay, so in actually your secondary storage devices are holding the some information. So means your until your users are deleting. Okay, it is just holding the information our secondary storage devices. So when it will be deleted, okay, when it will be remove the data, so here until your user involves, until your user involves, if you need you can store, if not here you can remove that one, if not here you can remove that one, right? And next here, secondary memory is a one type of non-volatile. Here, this one is also non-volatile. Means your user only deleting means here, we can call this one is the non-volatile. When you are switching off your computer, it is just not lost the data. It is just not loss. There is no loss in the secondary memory. So this is not temporary memory. So this is for longest memory. So when the user only deletes the file, so it will be deleted in that. That's it. Okay. And in this actually we have the two types of secondary memories. What we have the two types here. First one is the disk drives. Okay. And the second one we have tape drives. Here first one we have the disk drives and second one we have the tape drives. Okay, means your disk drives is having the floppy, hard disk. Okay, tape drives is having the cartridge, cassette, like this here we have. Okay, so first we will discuss the disk drives. Okay, first one. Disk drives, right? We have the various types of disk drives. First disk drive is the floppy disk. First we have the floppy disk. Okay, so here this floppy disk is one type of magnetic disk. Here this is the one type of magnetic disk. This floppy disk is in the shape of a circular. This floppy disk is having the magnetic disk. Okay, so this is in the circular manner and also flat piece made of mylar plastic. It is made by the, this floppy disk is in the shape of a circular. It is having the flat piece and made of mylar plastic. So it is plastic only, but in that we have the types of plastics, right? So here it is using the mylar plastic. Here floppy disk is the one type of magnetic disk. So it is in the circular manner, and also it is in the some flat surface. Okay, so this one is made by the mylar plastic. This one is the made by the mylar plastic. Okay, and next here, so it is coated by, yes, this is made by the mylar plastic, but it is coated by the ferric oxide. Okay, it is coated by ferric oxide. Okay, it is coated. Okay, in the means you are in the box. Okay, so this is the plastic, right? So in the box type we have. Okay, so in that we just coated like a ferric oxide, and also here we are enclosing with that into plastic cover. Okay, just here we are using the ferric oxide, and also here we use the enclosed that one with the plastic cover. Okay, so not like we are using the covers, right? Not like that. Okay, so this is another type here. It is using the plastic cover also. So okay, so and it is also using the one protecting shield. It is also using one protecting shield. Okay, so why? Because here without these, suppose you are getting any power problem, or else suppose you are getting the any situations. Okay, so it will be lost the data. So that's what here we are giving the some coating like this, and we are protecting with the shields, and we are giving the covers to these like this. Okay, and here it is having the, okay, so it is just it is taking like operations, rotating the disc. Like means your we have the CDs, right? We have the CDs. Okay, so like that only before this we have. Okay, means your it is this floppy disk is also in the rotating manner. So suppose you are placed the CD, so how it will be rotating? So once here it is processing, means here it is rotating. Same like that only in this floppy disk also performing. Okay, so it is rotating the disk. What we have the floppy disk, that is here rotating the disk. And once it is rotating the disk, means here we can call that is reading the data. That is reading the data. Okay, what you are storing into that here, that is reading. Okay, same like CD. So okay, suppose you place it the one CD. Suppose we can call this is the one CD. So floppy disk also, I will send you the pic for you. Okay, so here once our CD is revolving like this, okay, revolving this, then what we are calling here, this is playing the songs, or else it is suppose you are transferring the one file computer to the CDs, means here it is just it is taking the information, means here it is just revolving like this. Okay, revolving like this means here it is taking the data, it is taking the input. Okay, we can call this same like that. Here we are working the our floppy disk. Same like that, you are working the floppy disk. Okay, and next here we have so actually where we are using, means here in the PCs we are using this one. So but nowadays here we are not using. Okay, so we remove this floppy disk from the computer, we just place it another one. Okay, so but if you have any computer or anything before this, just see this. Okay, so here nowadays we are using this floppy disk, right? And next year we have the another one is the hard disk. Another one what we have, second one is the hard disk. Okay, so nowadays we are using this hard disk into our computer. For what we are using? To store the data. For what here? To store the data. Okay, so where we have this hard disk? Okay, I will say. Okay, so here hard disk is the one primary storage. Hard disk is the one primary storage of the computer system. Here hard disk is the one primary storage of the computer disk. System. Okay, so here this hard disk we can also call like, okay, hard drive or else fixed disk. We can call this is a hard disk, we can call hard drive, or else we can call this one is the fixed disk. Okay, we are fixing the our hard disk into the our system, our CPU. Right, we can call this hard disk is also like a hard drive, or else we can call this one is the fixed disk, or else we can call this one is the fixed disk. Right, so here in this disk we are take how it will be like this disk. Okay, so it is having the stack of disk platters here. It is having the stack. Stack means here one after another. Okay, we can call here stack means here one after another. It is having the platters, platform like this. Okay, so it is having the like lines or anything. Okay, so it is having the stack of disk platters. It is having the disk. Okay, hard disk is having the stack of disk platters. You can call here hard disk is the hard drive or else fixed disk. We are fixing that one. We are not removing. So yes, if you need, you can remove. If you have any problem or anything, only you are removing. But it is in the fixed situation. Okay, for what we are using means here is storing the every information into that. Okay, so your this shape or this is how it will be in the like stack of disk platters. Okay, and these platters are made by the aluminium. Okay, so we have the platters, right? These platters are made by the aluminium. Okay, these platters are made by the aluminium alloy. Okay, these platters are made by the aluminium. Okay, right here. And also this is having the magnetic material coating. Okay, these platters are made by the aluminium alloy. Okay, but it is also having the okay magnetic material coating. It is having the magnetic material coating. It is having the magnetic material coating also. So here it is having the one protecting layer. Yes, we are giving the magnetic material coating means here it is having the one protecting layer, and that protecting the disk from the crash. Okay, means here suppose your system is getting any fire or anything. Okay, so in that time here, by that year we are not we are giving the protection to that. Okay, so it once you are giving the magnetic material coating, okay, so and we are giving some protection layers to that, so it will not burn like that. Okay, so just how it will have like that only we have. So suppose maybe it will be lost, means it will lost just data only. Okay, it will just lost the data only. Okay, and so this not only hard disk, we have different types of also. So everything why we are using means here to store the data only, to store the data only. And your hard disk is holding the data ranging from several hundreds of megabytes to several gigabytes. It is storing the okay hundreds of okay it is storing the hundreds of megabytes to gigabyte. Yes, we have the terabyte also. Okay, normally we are not using the terabyte, but in the suppose you are storing the so much of data means here you are using the terabyte hard disk. Okay, and your the speed of hard disk is measured by the how much you are accessing the information. So that is depending on the accessing time. Okay, so this is the hard disk. Yet nowadays we are using this hard disk also. And next we have the third one is the CD-ROM. Okay, CD-ROM. Okay, so this CD-ROM, yes, everyone knows this CD-ROM. So your CD means your compact disk. We can call your CD means your compact disk. ROM means your RAID only memory. Your compact disk. Compact disk. RAID only memory. We can call this only, this one is the compact disk. Everyone knows this one series, and everyone using, everyone buying this one also. Okay, see, so this is also one non-volatile memory. So this is not easily erasable. Once your users are erasing only, it will lose the data. Otherwise it will not lose the any data. So once we are removing means here it will lose. Okay, once you are switching off the computer, there is no loss for the CDs. It is just how much you stored, that is in the our CDs only. Okay, and here just why we are using these CDs means here to store the like text. Okay, so suppose this we have right this text like this. Okay, or else you can store the pictures. Okay, or else you can store the graphics if you have any graphics. Okay, or else you can store these sounds, okay, music like this, or else you can store these some animations. I think everyone knows the animations. Okay, so why we are using CDs means here to store the text, or else pictures. Pictures means your images. Okay, graphics, any graphics is there. Okay, sounds means your music, animations, not for the videos. Your CD is not for the videos. Why? Because your there is no lot of capacity to this. Okay, so if you need to be store the videos, you just you have to be use the DVDs. That's it. Okay, and here and the CD-ROM was who invented? Okay, so yeah, Sony and the Philips, those people are invented in the 1984. I think I already told this one in the history like this. Okay, so let's write here by using this here we can read only, we cannot write this one. Okay, means here suppose you have a text or a pictures or everything will be in the our system, just we are transferring the every file to the our CDs, just right. So but you're we are reading that one. Okay, we cannot edit or anything, we cannot do anything, just we are reading that one. Okay, and here and this we cannot alter, means we cannot modify or we cannot rewrite by these CDs, don't forget this one. And your CDs are taking for where it is taking means your information computers like this. Okay, so your CD ROM size, okay, we have the size is like 120 mm. Okay, and it is having the means your it is having the size. Okay, it is having the size is like 120 mm. CD size, okay, CD we have the round type, right, that is having the 120 mm and it is storing the just 720 MB only, just it is storing the 720 MB only, not much it is not storing. Okay, it is just storing the 720 MB and it is just for it is just is in the 120 mm only. It is just in the 120 mm only. Okay, so see here. Yes, see this. This is the one CD. So this is made by the Sony company. Okay, so just in this we are storing the 700 MB only. Yes, this is CD. So we have like we can place the finger. So suppose you place the this one into computer, it is reading the data means here it is like this, it is revolving like this. Okay, it is revolving like this. Okay, so means here it is revolving means here it is reading the data, it is reading the data. Okay, nowadays we are using this CDs. Okay, so this CD is occupied only 700 MB only, not normally we have the 720, but this CD, okay, but this CD is just taking the 700 MB storage. Okay, so your CDs are invented by the Sony and the Philips, right? Your this is the Sony company, this is the Sony company. Okay, so here we have the size. Okay, this is having the 120 mm, this is having the 120 mm, this is having the 120 mm size, and it is having the 720 capacity. Okay, right, and next year, sorry, 700 only. Okay, it is having just 700 only, not 720. Okay, so like this here we have the CDs, right? By this you can read only, you cannot write. Okay, read only, right? Okay, so and next we have the tape drives. At last we have the tape drives, second one we have the tape drives. Okay, we completed our disk drives, and next year we have the tape drives. By using these tape drives, you can just perform the means here it is in the magnetic tape performance. It is in the magnetic tape performance. Here just it is having the magnetic tape means here these magnetic tapes are in the plastic tape. It is in the plastic tape performance. It is in the plastic tape means your it is just using the magnetic coating around it. It is just having the magnetic coat, and these are in the small magnetized or demagnetized. Okay, so like this means it is just having the one bit like binary digits like zeros and ones. Okay, so just it is using the cartridge drive and cassette drive. In the old days we have the cartridge and cassette. I will send you the images for that. By that you will understand. Okay, cassette means your it is showing like this. It is in like this. Okay, so for this here we have the one magnetic wire. Okay, so this is like it is revolving, and it is revolving once you are starting the so like this we have. Okay, once you are starting that one, it is playing the song. So or else it is showing like clipping clip of the voice like this. Okay, so I will send you the image how we have the cassettes and cartridge tapes. Okay, and next year you can work this one in the USB flashlights. I mean your USB flash drives. Okay, or else you can work with the memory cards. Everything your tape drives are the our nowadays we are removed like cassette and cartridge. So at present we are using the mostly memory cards. Okay, this is also one secondary device. Okay, so these are the your primary devices, internal and memory devices. Okay, so this is your memory hierarchy. In next class we will discuss the another topic. Thank you.